You are now tuned in to Power Podcasts, the Empower Hour. Peace and blessings, beautiful souls. I am Brandi L. Bates, author of Moonshine for the Soul, The Art of Grind, and many other books. I'll be your host for tonight. You can find me on Twitter at Soledad Francis and on Instagram at Brandi Is Winning. Most of these podcasts can be found archived on YouTube, hashtag Power Podcasts, but please listen to them while they still have all of their spirit and vitality by subscribing to us on iTunes, Spotify, SoundCloud, and or BrandiBates.podomatic.com. Cheat codes. Stop following the crowd because they are lost. Do you hear me? It's rare that you meet someone who is whole, balanced, and at peace in their life. It's so common to find others who either hate their job, secretly don't like their wife or husband or babe or boo thang, in competition with siblings, in competition with family, you know, parents secretly in competition with their kids, or just garden variety depressed, miserable, living a life slightly below their potential. And I'm not just talking about, you know, I'm not talking about, for some, you know, you might think that's, you know, wow, that's negative as fuck. Like, damn, that's your reality. And really, that's not even my reality. That's not my reality. Now, it did used to be my reality. That was once upon a time my reality. Knowing people like this, experiencing people like this, being a person like this, right? And then I've figured some shit out. Like, the world puts those souls in the history books. You know who goes in the history books? Who goes down in history? Who goes down in, you know, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Who goes down in the Guinness World Records? Who goes down wealthy, rich, remembered? Those who leave a fucking dent in this universe. Those who, you'll know they're important, because sometimes you don't even have to hear the whole name. You just hear the last name, right? Einstein, Disney, Basquiat, MJ, Beyonce, Plato, right? Oprah. The world puts those souls in the history books who live, work, perform, serve, operate, and move within their potential. Instead of fighting your inner demons, today, I challenge you, instead of fighting your inner demons, examine them with curiosity. Like, really learn why they are there. Don't get brand new. You know what I'm talking about. Don't get brand new now. Try to understand your shadow self. Do the shadow work. What does that look like? Have a spirited debate with your darkness. Anything that tugs and pulls at your heartstrings, and only you can know your demons by name. I'm talking about the shit you don't share with people. Right? I'm talking to the person right now. Shit you dealing with, you can't even talk to people about, because this shit is so, it's embarrassing. It's in part, it's embarrassing. It's some shit you haven't figured out yet. You don't understand it fully. You know, you Googling shit, you looking at YouTube videos, you trying to like pray your way through and fasting. What Solange say? Try to drink it away, try to sex it away, try to work it away. And you just trying to figure this thing out, right? That's why, listen, you can meet people. See, we gonna unpack this shit tonight. That's why you can meet people who, to the world, by the world standards, right? By all physical appearance, really have their shit together. I mean, beautiful, you know, buff, just buff and tucked and tight and fine and paid and fabulous, right? A bad bitch, right? That bitch. You're that dude, right? But then inside are just as vapid, vacant, empty, and ran the fuck through. Ran through. Empty. Hello? A beautiful, broke down palace. Drop dead gorgeous in the face. But dead from the neck down. What do I mean? Spiritually inept and powerless. Right? You fine. You got your shit together on paper. Right? You got the paper. You got the degrees. You got the house. You got the cars. You got the all of that. Yeah, all of the titles and baubles and bells and whistles. But inside, broke the fuck down. Beat down. Tired. Depressed. Anxiety. That's who I'm talking to. That's what I'm talking about. But holding it together. You holding it together, right? We holding it together with bubble gum and Gorilla Glue. It's bubble gum and Gorilla Glue in this motherfucker holding you together. But deep down, you are in shambles. But nobody, you know, the thing is this. We were all sold a bag of goods. Right, some people were sold the religion bag, you know, you can pray about it and fast and pray and get right and live right, you know. Some of us were sold the education bag, go to school, get your degree, you can, you know, you can make good money doing that, right? Marry into it, be in relationship with the right person to help carry you on, right? But the reality is that nobody can live an abundant for whole life, a life of health, wealth, happiness, abundance, eating well, your mind right, your heart right, at peace, right? At peace with yourself, because you got to live with you. All this old bullshit that you know we do for other people because that's society standards of what we're supposed to be doing, right? That at the end of the day is not going to satiate you. It's not going to fill your cup. Because we all come here with unique callings on our life and purpose and direction and journeys. That's why you got to be careful with listening to everybody and taking everybody's advice. I would rather resonate with two people and they really, really feel in what I'm saying and lock in and really like elevate off that than 2,000 or 200,000 or 2 million people hearing it, but there's no lock-in, right? There's no buy-in. Nobody can live an abundant life who's constantly limping on E, who's operating from a diminished capacity. We're talking about cheat codes. Melanie Mushigian Kolaris said, once you become consciously aware of just how powerful your thoughts are, you will realize everything in your life is exactly how you allow it to be. And I'm saying to you today, your inner demons, offer them your love and understanding. Like really fuck with them. Like fuck with them the long way. So you can begin to do the work of healing mind, body, and soul. Spiritually, mentally, physically, emotionally, psychologically. Trauma changes the body permanently. Let me show you how this will affect your bag. This will affect your future. This will affect your love life. This affects your career. This affects in many ways your health, your mindset, right? Part of getting intimate with your inner demons is understanding the generational trauma and issues we tend to sweep under the rug and act like don't exist as families, as communities, tribes, and cultures, right? How, for instance, in the States, in the U.S., in the U.S., in the U.S., in the United States, where I'm located, right, we have a huge race issue. And it's the big fucking fluorescent purple polka dot pink and blue motherfucking elephant in the room. And everybody looking at this motherfucking elephant like, this shit is wow. Like, really? Like, you're really judging somebody. You're looking at their skin, and that's what you're judging them by. This is a whole spirit with ideas and a history, and they bring, you know what I mean, skill sets to the table. But you're seeing a complexion on their skin, and this is how you're going to judge them. And we're talking intelligent, educated people. Right? High up. We're not talking about dumb. We're not talking about, right? And it's so many issues that we just gloss over. We don't want to deal with within the black community. You know, we deal with race. We can't help but deal with that, right? But we will gloss over sexuality. We will gloss over abuse. We will gloss over childhood trauma. We will gloss over just dysfunctional shit on all levels that goes on generation after generation, and everybody overlooking it, right? You got the family pedophile. You got the family fuck up that's just keeping Big Mama in and out of the poorhouse, you know, refinancing and remortgaging her house to get you out of prison, right? We just don't talk. We sweep it under the rug and we act like this shit don't exist. But this is something that many, 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 many people and families are experiencing. In other countries, it's the misogyny. It's how women are treated, how women are put just constantly underclass, basically. Never really given an opportunity to elevate. Just different issues with different socioeconomic ramifications and consequences on a spiritual level, on a financial level, just depending on the nation you're talking about, just depending on the religion, depending on the dominator culture, right? The ancestors, one thing all wisdom schools teach is to know thyself. And the shit is so basic and yet so profound at the same time. There's an ancient Egyptian proverb that says, know the world in yourself. Know the world in yourself. Never look for yourself in the world, for this would be to project your illusion. Know the world in you. I always meet me. Every relationship, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your coworkers, your supervisor, your subordinates, your customers, your clients, your clientele, all are different reflections of you. Especially your deep, nobody is incidental. Nobody is accidental. There's no one who comes into your life for any prominent period of time who is accidental. For your frequencies to even cross paths, y'all gotta be vibrating on the same kind of level in some way. Even that's why sometimes it could be two people from two different cultures, two different backgrounds, right? Two different classes, religion, all that, and sometimes have so much in common, more so than people who look like you and come from your same village, right? Cheat codes. Take this with you. Master solitude. Master solitude. And master pain. Pain is something to be mastered. Learn to alchemize pressure. Pressure busts pipes, but also pressure makes diamonds. So either pressure is either going to mold you or fold you, baby. That's what pressure is going to do with you. It's either going to mold you or you getting folded up. Either you going home crying with your ass in your hand, or you going to come through some breakthrough. Your bag is going to grow. You're going to be wiser. You're going to be stronger. You're going to be better. You're going to go further. You're going to move the needle just a little bit on the record of your life. It's either going to do one of the two. There's really no in between. And if there is no pressure, you just existing. You just floating. And one thing about it is a lot of people, they're just floating through this shit. There's no goals. There's no direction. So motherfuckers just at the wheel of government and laws and happenstance. And they might get hexed. They might run across a brouhaha, right, and get cursed. They might run into, they just floating. You just floating. You don't have any aim, baby. So if you don't have any aim and you don't have any direction and you don't have any, nothing is pointing you and aiming you into something with purpose, then you're floating. Pressure. Turn it into fuel. Learn to master it. Learn to alchemize it. Learn to work with it. Learn to work with energy. Don't work against it. Right? Turn it into fuel to power your purpose and your ideas. And use it as electricity to move you and to move you in your calling through this life. Like literally, if you're listening to this, you got here. If you're listening to this right now, chances are you got here by having strong ass, smart, intelligent, emotionally intelligent ancestors that survived. So you already have greatness in you. You have everything you need inside to get the job done, whatever that job may be. Like everyone who is living right now, you've come through bloodlines and bloodlines of people who have survived, you know, ice ages and you know what I mean? Who have survived the agrarian age and the industrial revolution, and for many the American Revolution and civil wars, and oh my goodness, right? You come from people who have survived genocide and apartheid. And in many cases, have overcome plagues and disease and famine, right? Let's be real about it. Your oldest ancestor, they have seen some shit. And we can't, here's the deal though. We can't take any of this shit with us. That house, those cars, your shoes, all that shit. Red bottoms, Cuban links, Yves Saint Laurent. You can't take any of that shit with you. Solitude. Solitude is where you will be able to examine your life. The examined life. Where you really find the self. Solitude, where you really find the self, not governed by your subconscious programming and cultural programming. Solitude is where your ideas can walk around with no bra, a bonnet, and house shoes, right? Where your thoughts can let their balls hang, right, fellas? You know what I'm talking about. When you get to get home, right, take them pants off. That's where all the truth and authenticity is. Most of your life is dress rehearsal. Opening night. Lights, camera, action, flash, focus, record. That's rare, few, and far in between. Right? Most of your life is just the homogenous ebb and flow of life. It's those rare experiences. It's the rare relationship. It's the rare opportunities. Flash in a pan type of experiences where, you know, you've come across some greatness. You know, you have crossed paths with an angel. You know, you have stumbled across something supernatural or serendipitous, right? Osho said, the capacity to be alone is the capacity to love. Solitude. That's one of the biggest cheat codes. The capacity to be alone is the capacity to love. It may look paradoxical to you, but it's not. It is an existential truth. Only those people who are capable of being alone are capable of love, of sharing, of going into the deepest core of another person without possessing the other. See, a lot of times we want to possess people. You don't possess anybody. Parents, you don't even possess your children. You are a conduit. You are a vessel to bring them forth. You don't possess them. You're never going to own a nigga. You're never going to own a broad. You're never going to own a man. Never going to own a woman. You don't own people. We can't own people. I don't know who needs to hear this. Without becoming dependent on the other, without reducing the other to a thing. Because that's another thing we like to do, is we objectify one another. Do we not? And without becoming addicted to the other, we do that too. Because a lot of times when you've fallen in love, especially new love, in many ways, it mimics the same chemical reaction as addiction. The same hormones are produced. The same type of dopamine and serotonin flying off the handles, right? Allow the other absolute freedom. Because even if somebody leaves you, even if you lose a job, even if you lose an experience, or you're no longer in school, or you're no longer, you know, doing your flow, you're still going to be as happy as you are then. You're happy as you want to be. You're happy as you make yourself to be. You're as free as you believe you are. You're as young as you feel and believe you are and act. Happiness cannot be taken away by another person or a position. Because it's not given by another person or a position. Right? The old heads used to say, don't let the world take your joy. Don't let nobody steal your joy. Don't let nobody steal your joy. Don't let the world take your joy, because the world didn't give you your joy. That's from inside. That's really an inside job. So today, really try to understand. Try to understand your generational stuff. You have to understand the phobias. Stay with me. I promise you I'm landing somewhere with this. You have to understand the phobias, fears, obstacles that have moved down your bloodline. It's so important. Really have those talks with your dad and your mom and your great aunt and people before they die. Try to have those conversations before they're gone. Because some people, when they're gone, you no longer have access to information about your heritage, right? Or your lineage, which ultimately is your blueprint and can kind of guide you. Royal families on every continent understand this. On every continent. Whatever the royal family, the wealth class family is, I promise you, they know their ancestry down 30 plus generations. How come our ancestors carved everything into stone except for Jesus? They carved everything into stone, didn't they? Because they knew people would come along and write shit and make shit up and make up lies. But you can't lie about something carved into some stone. You can change some computer code. Speaking of which, Mandela effect in full effect. How many of you remember how many of you remember Ed McMahon knocking on people's door with the publisher's clearinghouse check? So how about the Mandela effect has erased that? That never happened. Ed McMahon never worked for Publishing Clearinghouse. Google it. Check it out. Never happened. Never happened. See how they change history? They can rewrite history. They can go in and change the computer code. They can go into the simulation and go into the matrix and change some shit up. And all of our memories now don't mean shit. Because we can't prove it. But you can't prove. You can't debate what's carved into some stone 600 feet in the air, right? You can't debate that. You can blow off some noses, but you can't completely, right? Because sometimes when you really begin to unpack your stuff, you find that you don't even agree with or buy into or want to continue subscribing to the bullshit you've been fed up to this point. How much of your culture is adapted versus how much of it is adopted? Why do you eat the way you eat? Why do your people dress the way they dress? Why do they think the way they think? Why do they allow women to, right, exist how women exist, or how men move, and who holds, who carries the family name, and so forth and so on, right? That's cultural. But the real development happens. That's where the real development happens, is when you begin to question some of these beliefs and some of these traditions and just really understanding where this shit is coming from, right? Intelligent people, intelligent adults, every day are scammed because they don't do diligence. They don't question. They don't just go look and see, is this accurate, right? Did you know? Developmental trauma causes permanent changes in the bodies and the brain structure and chemistry. Generations later, the body's stress response, your body's stress response, is an interactive, multi-system response to trauma. So we're talking about extreme emotional events. It can be a wedding, it can be a new baby, it can be rape, it can be abuse, it can be watching someone get shot, it can be getting your ass kicked all through third grade, right? Whatever extreme emotional event with a lot of emotion and a lot of passion and a lot of energy behind it. Stay with me. It's a reason I said that. Any extreme emotional event that is processed through the sensory systems via the thalamus in the brain, right? From there, from your thalamus, stay with me. I'm going in a little neuro. Y'all know I'm a nerd. From the thalamus in the brain, from there, the amygdala is then activated. And in this part of the brain detects fear and anxiety. The amygdala detects fear and anxiety. That's, you hear a dog barking. You know a dog is behind you. A dog is chasing you. You know that somebody is walking up behind you, or somebody's been following you. Or you go to open a door and you see a shadow move. And nobody's supposed to be there, right? In other words, this is how it all begins. The body senses danger through its senses, which is processed by the thalamus. Stay with me. And then relate to the amygdala as an urgency to be afraid. Be very afraid. Like, bitch, wake up. Some shit finna happen. All right. Now, that's when the hairs stand up on your skin goosebumps, and you are standing at attention. Your hearing is heightened, right? That moment is fight or flight, right? The fear that is produced next in the body signals to neurons in the prefrontal cortex, in the hypothalamus, and in the hippocampus. And then activity begins to increase in the locus, coeruleus and what you know is your sympathetic nervous system. And then activity that is meant to protect you. So something turns on a chemical level. These are just chemicals. This is chemical. All this happens when something turns on your fear. Cheat code. Stay with me. So the body is alerted to danger. And this elevates the heart rate. And this increases metabolism. And this raises blood pressure. And it ramps up your alertness. And at the same time, your biochemical systems are launched into response. And so your body is flooded with hormones needed to fight or flight. These are your endorphins. That's why there are stories of, you know, mothers who've picked up cars because their child was stuck in the car. A woman will lift up a whole goddamn 4x4, right? You hear stories of men who jumped over 3 and 4 buildings, right? Just craziness. Those are endorphins. Makes the human body almost superhuman. It elevates your cortisol. And it decreases other non-essential hormones. So that's why if you're being chased by a dog, you're not going to be able to be aroused at the same time. That's why when you're afraid or you're fearful or you're worried, you lose your appetite. Or when you're depressed or you're sad and you're sulking and you're melancholic, you can't eat. You lose your appetite. You can't even sleep. You just, right? That's hormones. That's chemical. I'm saying to you, all of this, when that happens, this creates lasting structural change. It doesn't matter if it happened at the hands of a bully. It doesn't matter if it happened at the hands of an abusive parent or a neighborhood human eyesore, right? Over time, the body's alertness to danger informs the body that it must be ever ready to flee or to seek protection. And so this causes changes in the heart rate, in the metabolic rate, blood pressure, your alertness, and it stimulates the body to produce inflammation. Which in normal circumstances, right, if you're really being chased by a bear or you're really being chased by a coyote, right, that's part of our body's recovery mechanism. We need that. But the inflammatory response goes into overdrive in traumatic circumstances. And so all of this also has an ongoing effect on lowering the immune system more broadly. So over time, it opens you up to shit. This creates a lasting biochemical change. That's why now a lot of studies in epigenetics can see how children of extreme trauma, it damages them so bad later into life, more so than kids who they had a really pretty much cherry life, you know, childhood. Who run into some stressful shit later, they're able to bounce back a little more than those who just experience nothing but just fucking trauma and abuse and bullshit, right? People who have suffered developmental trauma have permanently lower levels of cortisol in their bodies because they create cortisol, which again is the stress hormone. Cortisol is the stress hormone. And because they're creating that more often and with less provocation, this is another way of saying that the body goes into a biochemical stress response easily and too often, which decreases the body's cortisol storage. Same way as you keep eating sugar and sugar and sugar, you keep pumping insulin, pumping it. Eventually your body says, you know what? Fuck it. We done. We not doing no more insulin. So now, when you need insulin to regulate the sugar in your blood, it's not pumping anymore, baby. That's diabetes, right? Takes you out of here. It will take you out of here. So, it's been shown that there is an epigenetic factor as well, generations later. For instance, the descendants of the transatlantic slave trade, the descendants of Holocaust survivors, the descendants of those who lived through the American Revolution, the American War, the Civil War, Jim Crow, right? Lynchings, watching all of this, all of the descendants of this, is who I'm talking to. Low cortisol levels. This is how intergenerational trauma works at the level of biochemistry. Do you hear me? And so the body's natural levels of oxytocin, which is your bonding hormone. That's the love chemical that's produced by mothers when you're breastfeeding your child. Your body produces all this oxytocin and you just fall in love with your child and you want to give them life, right? When you are deeply in love with someone. And dopamine, the feel-good hormone, right? You eat you some good, warm, hot, freshly baked cookies. Or you get you some really, really good food. Or really good sex, right? Or really good, right? Whatever your really good is, it's producing the dopamine in you, right? And serotonin, the happiness chemical, right? All that shit, when you get excited about shit, you buy a lottery ticket and you know that you might just win this. You might win. That, all of that is producing a chemical, biochemical reaction in your blood. But again, when you have low cortisol levels and you're dealing with intergenerational trauma, you're dealing with generational curses, you're dealing with generational stuff that you have yet to address and unpack and deal with and manipulate and work with this energy, all of that is compromise. Machiavelli said, "Whosoever desires constant success must change his conduct with the times. Don't chase, don't beg, don't stress, just relax." I don't know who I'm talking to. Relax. This shit will pass. You will be fine when you relax. Because guess what? Getting worked up and you getting worried and you, oh my God, that's not going to do shit. It's not changing the situation. It's not fixing anything. It's not generating any income in your bank account. It's pointless. It's worthless. It's useless. But when you relax, it will come to you. See, that's how you make your wants want you. Make your wants want you. The law of attraction is always operating. You couldn't have been created had there not been some type of attraction between your two biologicals, because they were the conduits. There are some people you are only meant to meet, that person, to fall in love just enough to have a child with that person, and that child later grow up to become someone great and mighty and powerful, to do mighty and powerful things on this earth. But the two biologicals, they were just the conduits to move the bloodline. That's it. To move the code. Right? Packaging the larger purpose. Everything moves through conduits. Your creativity will set you free. Every great artist elevated their whole family's existence through their body of works, either while they were living or after they died. Oftentimes, it's after they die. But every great artist, whether they are sculptor, painter, singer, songwriter, dancer, culinary artist, architect, elevated their whole family's existence through their art, through their voice, through their beats, through their skills, through their thoughts and ideas. Thoughts and ideas move the world. Culture, the artists, move the world forward. Nothing will liberate you but your mind. Physical fighting, fighting with the fist. The pen is always going to be mightier than the sword. Physical fighting, battle, warfare can only do what a fraction of what cooperation and an ideal spreading like wildfire can do. You think about your most adored singer or actor or athlete, etc. You name it. If they're iconic, they can pack out stadiums of people who pay good money to be entertained. And in no other area or arena of life do people willingly give of themselves, give of their money, their time, their vulnerability, their energy. You take the NFL, you take the NBA, you take the NHL, right? The revenue that is generated just from the NFL and the NBA and Hollywood, the box office, it's that of small countries' whole GDP, their whole GDP. The NFL and NBA and Hollywood and the billboard, right? They generate this shit in a fucking year. They generate more revenue and income and money than whole countries will see in a lifetime. And it was all given freely. You didn't have to fight the people. You didn't have to enslave them. You didn't have to shackle them. You didn't have to imprison them. You didn't have to tax them. You didn't have to beat them over the head. Just give them art. Give them something good that speaks to their spirit. And they give you the money freely. They throw the money at you. They throw the money at you. You can say what you want about dancers, strippers. But to be able to have the power to get up on a stage and just with your natural body, have men just throw money at you. You don't have to say anything. You don't have to speak any ideas. Just stand up there, move a little bit, and they throw all this money at you. When you really think about the energy behind that, remove the judgment. Remove the judgment. And really think about the power of that. Do you hear me? Really let that marinate, like soak with that. Sit with that. Energy is our first language. Everything in nature, everything in the cosmos speaks in energy and utilizes energy as currency. We're just barely beginning to understand free energy. We're barely tapping the shit. The shit that powers fiber optics, the invisible spectrum, Wi-Fi, how things actually move through the hyperdimension. Science is barely catching up with ancient wisdom. Everything is frequency, vibration, and energy. Relationships, the people who you pull to you, the people who pay attention to you and don't pay attention to you, that's energy. That's frequency. You're not going to pull anything towards you that you're not resonating on the same wavelength. It just won't happen. It's just not going to happen. Even a dog can come into a room. A dog will come into a room and read the energy of the room and not fuck with the problematic person in the room. They'll already know who not. They'll run, they'll run off left to the left, right? Because they know the energy is something that's off with this person. That dog doesn't speak any English. That dog doesn't speak any language, but it speaks energy. And it is fluent in understanding energy. Babies too. Certain people, babies, when you immediately touch them, they'll either start crying or they'll rock with you. If you have a certain kind of spirit, a certain kind of energy, they either will rock with you or they won't. That's energy. It crosses cultures. It crosses everything. You will live most of your life inside your head. Inside your head. Your thought world is the steering wheel. It's the motherboard, the engine, and the projector. Your mind is your CPU in this simulation. So how your shit shows up on the big screen really is up to you more than you know. And if nothing else, this whole pandemic, quarantine, lockdown, all the fallout from it should have demonstrated how much of this shit has been an illusion. Like, how much wagging of the dog is happening. Like, we're starting to see these constructs for what they really are. And at the same time, we're being birthed into a whole new density. So this is new territory. And you can manifest shit that up to this point, it seemed impossible. I'm not talking about, oh, you want to, you know, you want to manifest a Lambo. You know, you can do that. You can do that. You can do that. And a lot of kids are doing it. A lot of these kids are doing it. They playing with the energy. That's what they want. And they make it happen. Right? But anything up to this point that you really couldn't really do in the past, you can do it now. The spirit is the real life. The mind is the builder, the blueprint, the specs, the model, the code. And then what results shows up in the physical. Thank you so much for listening. Today, do me a favor. Do me a favor. If your parents are alive, if your parent or parents are alive, love on them. Hug them. Do not underestimate or assume that you have them tomorrow or next week or next year. Same with your with your kids, with your brother or your sister. Get right. Get right with the people who matter. Get right with the people who matter. Because a lot of times we have our last conversations with people and we don't know that that's our last conversation with them. And it end on a bad note, or it end in some bullshit. It end in some negativity. It end in some confusion. Clear the air. Be the one to be the bigger person to clear the air. Like, keeping shit stirred up and going, it's not cute. It's not cute. And it really slows down the motion of everything you're trying to do. So I'm going to leave that there. Thank you so much. Be blessed.